Right, just need to move this rail in to continue. Base sapling. No, I don't. Damn it. God damn it.
Hey, Guffert. You're first again, Guffert. Like, three out of the last four times you're first. Not bad.
Probably using scripts.
Cheating. And also, hello, Eddie Sotorian, Kiki, welcome guys. So day 5 of building the quarry, it's looking good. I mean, I think overnight, Iceberg has been grinding away, Sky Rising as well. I think like, I don't know, 75% is done now. So, how are we gonna build this? Just a bit inconvenient, but yeah. Hey, Peachy! Yeah, welcome from Germany! Bruno, hey!
What?
Yeah, the Bruno from Uruguay. See you again. Stay going great. So Methods and I were finally part of a Herbicraft episode. If you have not seen it, check out Doc's latest episode.
Well, we've been part of plenty Hermitcraft episodes in the background.
I always wondered, I just wondered yesterday what you were recording all the time.
Yeah. I think it took us like 4 hours to set up all the command blocks, so Methods mostly did it.
Poor Mango was just called in and stood around there for like 3 hours doing absolutely nothing.
Well, it was, had fun exploring around, the server.
Yeah. Went a bit overboard.
I really hope it doesn't do anything down below. But it looks good. Should be fine. Yeah, this was not recorded on the actual Hermitcraft server, in case you're wondering. Just got a copy. I'm building a quarry. I have no idea what exactly I'm building right now. Just some slime block mess. Not sure what that part specifically does. But yeah, check out the progress. Now almost all of the bulky top part is done. And then the rest is basically building this vertical part, which goes really quick. As you can see, it goes really quick. Then just the roof is missing. And in the back we also got a lot of instant repeater lines. So we won't finish it today, but the goal of finishing this in 7 days, yeah, seems very realistic. Might even do it in 6. Oh, that piston's wrong. How many hours do you play per day on average? Well, it's hard to say what is playing and what is video production, what differentiated even. But yeah, probably spend like 40 to 70 hours on Minecraft per week.
Ha! Get a real job!
Yeah, the last month was definitely closer to 70, maybe a bit more. how many man hours do you think it will take to finish? I have no idea. I would estimate we got like 80% maybe now. So then we should have like 25 man hours left maybe. Something in that range. Can't say exactly. So it depends how quick people build.
Totally not building a 10 core birch leaf farm trying to get 100,000 birch leaves per hour.
Did you think about the 2-player farm you suggested?
No.
I think it might also be a good idea. But you can't get 100,000 leaves per hour anyway.
Yeah, you can't mine it, I know.
If I didn't do YouTube, what would I do instead? Just like a normal job, I guess. Not as extreme as Jab. He once said he would be homeless if he wouldn't work on Minecraft. Don't think that'd be the case for me.
I kind of want to doubt it. I kind of want to doubt that.
Just saying what he said.
I mean, maybe he meant like if he didn't get the opportunity to work at Mojang, he would have gone homeless for a while, but I mean, he seems to be a rather smart person. I don't know.
That's what he said. I hope that's what he said. Hope I remember that right, but Quite sure he said that. Thanks, Alessandro, for the sub. Oh, yesterday we finally reached another emote threshold of 200 subscriber points. It was over a year ago since we reached the last one, so I commissioned a new emote. Hopefully we're gonna get it soon. It's probably just gonna be a squirrel head.
Yeah, no mango hands.
No, first professional emote. No mango stash? No. But I think we actually have one more emote slot anyway, so if somebody has a really good idea. We also could get rid
mango
of some
hands.
Some older emotes again, like the birthday cake, or don't think anybody's using that frog still. Thanks, Zach, for the 5 bits. Yeah, a lot of progress was done since I worked on it the last time. Actually, yesterday after the gym, I was working on it as well for 2 hours, and Sky was on, Tap was on, we were working on it off stream. And then apparently this night, Iceberg was working on it again, and Sky was also on when I joined. So yeah, surprise. But this far now. So I think we can probably finish it tomorrow. Thanks a lot, KingSpy, for the €4.61. Really appreciate it, thanks. No, we're not gonna restart like Hermitcraft. I doubt there will ever be a SciCraft Season 2. Doubt it. Come on. Any advice for first time building a world eater? When you run it, definitely make sure that everything is loaded. It's the most important part, I guess.
Make a backup before you launch it.
It's also a good idea.
Shit's gonna go wrong.
Make sure that you
get
know.
Get Medica.
Make sure that you know how you can turn it on and off. That's important. Will there ever come a point where there's nothing left to do? Well, technically, there's always something to do. At least in a lifetime for a normal human in Minecraft, because there's so much you can do. But if you only focus it on like farms and that stuff, I also doubt we're gonna run out of stuff, because Mojang keeps breaking old things, adds new content. I don't think we're gonna run out of stuff to do. Ever consider joining Hermitcraft? Not really, but when I got into Minecraft and Minecraft YouTube, first was watching the Hermitcraft server, and of course I also thought it would be nice to play on its server, but not something I thought would ever happen. Yeah, now I'm just busy on a SciCraft server anyway, so. True, Nomefitz and I also part of at least one Hermitcraft episode. Even Doc's latest one. Yeah, definitely check that out in case you haven't yet. Doc M's latest episode. Mephits and I have a cameo appearance. Yep. I think the episode from today released it a couple of hours ago. I think it was 141. Yeah, Skyblock server is still running. This week I released a new video. And there will probably be one next week as well. Yeah, the IP did change.
Yeah, we're always really happy when Mojang breaks stuff so we can redesign simple concepts and make them worse than before. All for the technical Minecraft community.
Mending is smarter in 116. It's definitely nice. You don't have to take off your armor anymore. Wizard stars are a big part of crafting, but I can't find a good wizard skeleton farm. Do you have any ideas for one? Well, wizard skeleton farms are always quite a lot of work because you have to prepare the whole nether area. Not sure why you don't consider the other farms to be good. So there's definitely no shortcut to making a good wizard skeleton farm. Like 95% of the work is preparing the area for the wizard skeleton farm, the actual farm.
I mean, if you're in modded Minecraft, then there probably is plenty of shortcuts. Depends on what mods you're running. What mod pack are you using?
I'm not sure. Oh, it's modded.
Yeah.
Then I
mean,
no
a mod
idea.
Pack, I know quite some modded
skills.
Most hype for in 116, the Nether.
Wow.
Badumts.
For me, it's the ancient debris and the whole new tools. Really looking forward to grinding it out.
I mean, I like him, but I'm not really hyped for that.
I
I like that they introduced two new mobs that actually have a purpose.
I kind of hope that we'll see a bit more content. Hope that this wasn't
Scepter.
Wasn't it already? No, I did not experiment much with the huge fungi or the fungi trees there, since they're still quite broken. They can replace blocks if they grow and whatnot. Probably doesn't make much sense to start with farms. But maybe might give it a go on Tuesday or so. They won't update the Nether Fortress. I've seen recently a tweet, they won't. It's also good. Why would they waste time on revisiting old stuff? Rather see a new structure which is announced. So the piglins get their own structure, apparently.
Lol, so the modpack the guy is playing, it's like a Game of Thrones themed modpack. It totally has Lightmatica in it by Masati.
What?
Yeah, I'm just checking the mod list.
What?
Yeah.
Nice.
Awesome. I don't see a mod to stop mob spawning like the mega torches and stuff, but for example there's Thormcraft, so you could use the water candles which increase mob spawns in an area around them. But other than that, unless you find something to remove a large area or blow up a large area, then you don't see anything to make your wither skeleton farm better. Wither boss AFK farm. If you have the materials, you can AFK kill them. Too friendly. What is friendly? Certain aspects of the game are way too friendly.
Friendly?
Yeah, I don't know.
It's like a typo. Grindy?
Beacon is not grindy at all.
No.
Just gotta know how you do it. World record for the longest Minecraft stream is broken. Oh, the Joe Mama guy. He tried to raid. Did he do the 40 hours?
I remember we raided a guy once, tried to stream Minecraft for 72 hours.
Yeah.
Gave up after, I think, 16 hours or so.
I mean, 40 hours is definitely breakable. I played Minecraft for 36 hours before.
Oh yeah, I remember that. We actually we streamed the World Eater for 36 hours and Methods was there all the time.
Yeah. So I mean, at that point, if I wanted to break the record, I would have gone for it, make another coffee and pull another 5 hours in.
What would you gain from it, though?
Nothing. Pride and accomplishment. But 40 hours sounds definitely rather simple breakable.
Yeah, nobody should also keep track of those records that are really detrimental to her health. I don't think Guinness would actually keep track of those records. It's just not healthy to stream a longer and longer time.
I could do it without caffeine too, but why? Huh. Let me quickly. That guy's gone. Yeah, Nico, if someone is like that, go ahead and don't time him out. Make sure he doesn't come back again.
Yeah, this also wouldn't be something for me. I think I never skipped a night of sleep my whole life.
Never?
No.
Sheesh, Mango, you have to. We have to do that at some point.
No.
Yeah, have you never been at a LAN party back in the days?
Yeah, I've been, but I've always slept like 2 or 3 hours.
Weak.
Why? It's just not healthy.
Weak human material.
Even with the military, they also had a lot of stuff to do in the whole night. It was, but they definitely still got an hour or two of sleep here and there. Yeah, split up probably in like 6 or 7 10-minute parts of sleep. So yeah, I don't think I ever completely skipped a night of sleep and didn't sleep at all. Yep, the Quarry uses TNT. How does this collect the blocks? Probably best if you watch it, one of the videos we made about it. Rago42 on his YouTube channel just made a world tour. We explain the quarry. But yeah, how does it collect the blocks? You can see this water stream there. Items fall in there and get put in the storage. Yeah, we're working on the next world tour. Hopefully in 2 weeks. Built it separately, probably here in front. Oh yeah, the video quality was awful. Unfortunately.
Yeah, Rego really has to get that fixed. I mean, honestly, at that point, I wouldn't have released a video.
Maybe I can also release it. I didn't want to release it because I've already shown everything pretty much in the SciCraft episodes. So it's been quite redundant, but maybe I'll also release my point of view. Yeah, that maybe can do it tonight, to edit that. Mod or plugin?
There's no difference between a mod or a plugin. It's just what's the difference?
I think usually Spigot has so-called plugins.
Yeah, but they're basically just mods.
Yeah.
So. Best way to fill bedrock layers for a perimeter? Placing the blocks. Guess you could make a flying machine that transports sand over the whole area. And if it's at the very end, there's slabs to break off extra sand so you don't get stuck somewhere if there's no more holes left.
Best to stop the world here before it actually blows up the blocks between the bedrock. That's what we always did.
Yeah, but then there's always a few because there's dirt and other crap.
Yeah.
And Josie just fill in. The best way is just filling it in by hand. I mean, takes the least amount of time. It's not that much work.
Yeah, but if you blow up everything between a bedrock and then start filling
in. Well, then the machine is probably faster and less work. Yeah. Well, not faster, but
then less you work. Always will have some spots where mobs can still spawn in between.
Yeah.
Because TNT doesn't reach all the crevices and so on. Could be some spawning spaces left behind.
My favorite block is TNT. What's your favorite block, Mango?
The rotator block.
Ah, yeah, I like the one. So, the headless piston.
What's the best way to build this now?
I've seen a trick.
I think I saw it on stream. Tap was able to place the observer somehow. I'm not sure what she did.
Place the slime block and then place the observer?
Well, then I always get the pick block. And place an observer in that position, unless I could maybe aim
Why
at that.
Why do you get the pick block?
I could aim at that.
Huh? Ah, the piston isn't placed yet.
No.
Well, you can also just switch your Lightmatica settings to pick block last instead of pick block first. So it always picks the block that's furthest behind. That's way better, by the way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it works like that. I can. That's what. I'm not sure if you're watching the stream. If I do this and place it in observer because it clicks on the observer there.
Yeah.
If I do it from here,
pick block
it's fine.
Last.
From here, it's fine. Yeah.
If you pick block last, it would have clicked the slime.
Yeah, I've seen actually Tab somehow placing that observer immediately. I'm not sure how she did that.
Tweakaroo secret. You don't spoil the Tweakaroo secret.
They're passed on from family member. Family member.
Yeah. You have to earn them.
PC do you use? I should actually get paid for that. if I advertise for the components on, let's see, maybe.
You should actually just put your hardware setup in the description.
For what? It's just free advertisement for a lot of companies.
Okay, I guess then you're gonna get the question more and more. It's the one in the tower.
The black one.
Yeah. The black one. Does anyone want to play Minecraft Bedrock with me? Chat instantly dead.
Yeah, we're building the quarry. Next one. I haven't shown it yet. This stream is gonna take a little trip to the first quarry we've built. You'll see the final product and what it does. So this is what the quarry will do to the terrain in the end. So what's gonna happen on this side? Mines all the blocks, blows them up, sends them through a water stream to a storage. There we can see all the blocks we got from the first quarry. So all neatly put into shulker boxes, so we get a lot of dirt, terracotta, iron ore, redstone dust, coal, even some diamonds here and there, lapis. There's a diamond. How do you mine out the quarry?
The quarry is the machine and not the hole. The quarry mines the hole.
Yeah.
It's an automatic mining machine.
We refer to the machine that does it as the quarry. I know this is just... I'm not even sure who started it. I think it was Simply Sark. Zenkern.
Zenkern, yeah.
Like he just started it. No, yeah,
we
just
basically we use the term like in modded Minecraft where you have a quarry, just it's a little bit more than one block.
Mm-hmm. That's the final product. That's what we're building again a second time.
Could you make a tutorial and explain how to run a World Eater to have a completely flat floor? Didn't you get in one of the World Eater videos?
No, we did it a couple times on stream, but I never did that on. Maybe I did it actually.
Yeah, I have a feeling.
I think I actually did it.
Let me check.
But yeah. Want to update the World Eater anyway, because I was messing around recently with the Ancient Debris World Eater, and the honey block is actually useful here and there. Also for the old design. So I want to adjust it and make a tutorial about it. Can also show it with the flat floor. So it would be quite helpful for a lot of people to know that. Firework duration 4 and 5 should be released. I agree. I would like rockets. Yeah. For longer duration, for sure.
Yeah, your double speed World Eater for 1.12 explains how it works, and it should be the same for future World Eaters as well.
Mm-hmm. before doing YouTube, I was studying environmental engineering. I often use the duration 3 rockets, but we also offer duration 1 rockets. There's even some people that like the duration 2 rockets, but they have to craft them themselves.
Duration 2 rocket master race. Fight me.
Flexible block placement rotation. Mm-hmm. So, but I doubt if the turn is on now, it would work. No, I only got flexible block placement, not rotation. Is there an hotkey for that?
You just add more gunpowder.
Bracket. What is L bracket? Oh, yeah.
It's the left bracket.
Yeah, I still need my muscle mod keyboard. I don't think I have keys left for that. That's fine. I'm gonna do it like that, it's okay.
No one cares about the cost efficiency of rockets if you have a 1 million gunpowder per hour farm or even any creeper farm. Rockets are super free. Well, then you should make one. Or even better, make a witch farm. Which pretty much gives you enough gunpowder and redstone to do whatever.
Oh, ghast farm.
Yeah, but you know, early game, if you don't have all the farms yet, witch farm is definitely super good.
Yeah.
Redstone, glowstone, gunpowder, sugar, all the stuff. And spider
ghast
eyes.
Farm. Ghast farm is also really good.
At the moment. Not really. Yeah, if you want it fast, but early game, if you just want some to have enough, which farm's way better.
Yeah, creeper farm's also better in the desert. That is if the farm runs at mob cap. That's then your...
Yeah.
Amount of creeps is higher. Thanks, Jacobus90 for the sub.
Where you just wouldn't use sugarcane M33R. You would use melons. Well, I think sugarcane is also zero tickable in future versions.
Yeah,
in future versions. Mm-hmm. But I mean, if you don't use the zero tick farms, you probably want to use melons.
We used it once for the Schalke factory in Skyblock. They just needed bone meal to color Schalke boxes and grow some trees.
Yeah.
And I also used the sugarcane acerotic farm, it was just the easiest way to do it. If you don't use acerotic, then melons it is.
Yep.
Yeah. Actually hope that acerotic farms are getting fixed. Just ridiculous by now.
Yeah, so if your zero tick farm makes 16,000 sugarcane per hour, and what is sugarcane's chance to?
I think 50%, if I remember right.
50%, so you need like 3.5 sugarcane to get one bone meal?
No, you have 7 stages, so you need 14 sugarcane for one bone meal.
Yeah, on average 3.5.
No, 14 on average.
Oh yeah, you can't get half one. That's 14 sugarcane per bone meal, yeah. Then you can calculate what exactly, how many zero tick farms you need to run your 18k bone meal per hour tree farm.
Yep.
See your problem.
Yep. Yeah. Don't think composting is the best way to do it. Little skeleton farm. Probably better. Especially now in 116, if it stays like that, we can make skeleton only farms. It's also a good option.
Yeah.
We'll see if that still works in the future. Definitely looking forward to skeleton only farms, because faster XP farms.
I mean, of course.
XP farms, I mean.
Of course, building a quarry is worth it, otherwise, we wouldn't do it.
Yeah.
I mean, look at the gigantic hole the first quarry made, and of course it takes a long time to build the quarry, but it would have probably taken months upon months to dig it.
Well, spend so, 100 hours, then yeah. Digging for 1,000 hours.
And 10,000 hours digging. Yeah. This thing is actually like faster than 10 players mining 24/7, so... Yeah, of course, if you want to mine a lot of blocks with the quarry, don't just run a... build it like 10 blocks wide and run it for 20 blocks. That wouldn't be worth it.
This is definitely more effort to build than previous quarries.
Are you sure compared to the 11 block one with the huge thingy in the back?
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, what's actually now ahead? Just building a lot of those instant repeater lines, I think. Yep. Yeah, the bulk of the work is done, and then it's just the roof.
I'm working on the roof at the moment.
Okay. The thing here on the left, I think it's better if you just built it vertically, so I'm gonna ignore it for now. Solo build quarry speedrun when? Never. Just, I don't know. This would take at least 80 hours. Alone.
Also, why speedrun something where you don't have competition anyway?
What a fun. So this is probably the last quarry for a while now. Don't think we're gonna build another one in 112. definitely thought about making a quarry in the Nether. But we'll have to see. Especially if for some reason they don't fix the piglin scamming. Yeah, then we don't need to make a quarry for quartz.
The piglin scamming bug report is already in progress. It's getting fixed, yeah, 100%.
You know, what can happen just the site's work is intended is also...
Then the bug wouldn't be in progress.
We'll see. I mean, double pistol traction was also in progress.
Yeah, I mean, I can also ask Henrik.
Yeah.
But I'm 99.99999% sure it ain't staying.
Yeah, okay, just saying, if it stays for some reason, then we definitely don't need a quarry.
Yeah, it doesn't, though. We also don't need it if it doesn't stay. Can still get that stuff.
Also, we're gonna do a lot of World Eater probably for the ancient debris. And there, we can actually spend some time and just flying around
picking
and pick up so much quartz. So we're gonna get a lot of quartz this way anyway, so I don't think we need a quarry right now. We're gonna do a lot of that stuff anyway in 116.
Yeah.
Could the also make a funny? Little bit, maybe.
Could also make a smallish gold farm with a piglin trading center and just AFK it permanently with a bot. It would also yield quite a lot of quartz over time. How would you handle the ancient debris other than mining it? I mean, you would need a wither cage and push it there and whatnot. It doesn't sound worth it.
Hmm? What do you mean?
Someone said you could also make a... Wait, there's
a quarry for the ancient debris, it would also work. But the bedrock in the Nether is quite an issue. Maybe we'll also make a quarry. We'll see. Servers are useless now? Yes, they're completely useless now.
Yep. You wouldn't make a gold farm for piglins, you would make a gold farm to get gold ingots to trade.
You can also just blow up the ancient debris.
Yeah. You just have to move it.
Yep. That's what I use in a TNT blast chamber. Yeah. It's kind of well known that moving blocks have blast resistance 0, and it also includes the ancient debris. So you can blow it up with TNT, and the quarry here also does it. It's all timed. Yeah. A lot of people don't know that. Recently, I got like. Was it 3 DMs that discovered that as well? totally excited about
years.
It. Insane discovery, but yeah, we know that since years. Ancient B is just a movable block like any other block. Yeah.
No, I'm pretty sure if they make the Nether 256, they're gonna remove the bedrock roof. There's zero reason for it to so be there.
Historical reasons.
I mean, I'm the first one to make a bug report if it's still there, so... What qualifications do you need to play on the SciCraft server? You need at least a PhD in Minecrafting.
Also 5 years of experience.
Yeah. Eight years. Or even better, you know, 12 years experience in Minecraft.
Oh yeah.
I don't think the Nether Roof is meant to be the bottom of the overworld.
I don't know if there's any lore behind it. Yeah, why is there even some bedroll on top of the Nether? I don't get it.
Because they didn't want people to use the area that's completely empty back in the day.
Hell is obviously underground.
So if they would ever expand the Nether to 256, do you think there will be a 5-6 layer bedrock on top again? Or is it open?
No.
So you can just fly above the Nether completely.
Yeah.
Wouldn't this also be a bit weird?
Why would it?
I don't know.
I mean, the Nether is the only place that has it, and it was added so people don't use the empty area on top of there. The area is no longer empty. Isn't it a bit weird if it would stay? The overworld doesn't have a bedrock roof. The end doesn't have a bedrock roof.
I think it would be weird if there's no bedrock above.
Didn't the Nether had a bedrock roof before the world height was increased to 256?
Yeah. True.
You couldn't build anything on top of there at the beginning. Yep.
I don't know, I don't see a reason for it to stay. Just annoying.
Yep, the machines wouldn't come up with to remove the
bedrock. Yeah, upside down bedrock remover, but no Mango, you actually want it, so.
I just said I would expect it. Do I want it? No, hell no.
Should just not be there.
I mean, everything would be so easy.
It's completely unnecessary as well.
Everything would be so easy, yeah.
Oh, you still need to tunnel bore on top and whatnot. If you need space on top.
Yeah, but at least for your farm, you don't need to bedrock removal.
Yeah. The hermits should challenge themselves for season 7 when they go to the on 16 to leave the overworld and live in the Nether. Yeah, that makes epic YouTube content. Where you have like the insanely bad YouTube compression ruining every single video for like months upon months. I mean, no one is going to live in the Nether longer than like probably 3 weeks. Had the same in the 113. I
wanna see Mumbo Jumbo live in the Soul Sand Valley.
Yeah, good fun. Doesn't do spawning attempts on the bedrock, but the bedrock increases the max world height. Which in fact decreases the succeed rate of spawn attempts. Which, I mean, they could also fix that, right? I wouldn't mind it. Bedrock non-solid. Oh no, like... But it doesn't work in the new system. Like every block increases it.
Hey, thanks a lot, Lucifius, for the Twitch Prime sub.
I really don't know why Mojang really wants to make the Nether livable. It's like... This place isn't supposed to be nice, easy, and like...
But I really want that feature that you can set your spawn point in the Nether.
Why?
I wanna challenge myself by starting in the Nether, then try to fight back to the overworld, the Skyblock world.
Set your spawn point inside a portal.
Then I spawn in the overworld the next time, I mean.
Yeah, and you just challenge yourself to not actually go in there. Maybe there's some trickery so you can actually do it, like some instant teleportation abuse
then
stuff.
Command blocks can do everything.
No, without command blocks.
No, I would play Skyblock Nether. So no fortress, nothing. You only start with some dirt in a tree again.
Yeah, also probably wouldn't take too long to get some sort of Pikmin and Piklin farm going and get the obsidian.
Wouldn't be as hard as waiting for rain, I guess.
The hardest is probably the iron ingot, actually. You have to wait for some
you can just get
reinforcement spawn.
Ghast shoots at you.
Yeah, true. That also, yeah, it's probably easier than getting reinforcement spawns and getting an iron ingot drop from a zombie.
Oh, this would actually be also a nice idea. Yeah.
But you also really don't need to wait for... No, you don't have lava in Skyblock.
Oh yeah, everybody watch Doc M's latest Termicraft episode, because Methods and I... After the stream. Because Methods and I have a little appearance in there.
I have been so sick recently, I actually have to put on medicated chest rub about every 3 hours. Good job, Nightbot, banning that sentence. Chest rub is definitely offensive.
Chest rub? What? Good job, Nightbot.
Nightbot drunk again. You know, if there's someone who actually like needs to be banned or like something like that, Nightbot doesn't do anything. If it's like the most casual stuff, Nightbot kicks in.
Chest drop.
It's so useless.
Monday will be start of season 7, so tomorrow.
No.
No?
No. I think on Friday or something. Do you have Optifine enabled? I use like Medica and it's a bit glitchy.
Honestly, I don't know. Do we have Optifine?
I think it's one of the rendering options of Optifine or something. If you have troubles with that, I highly recommend you join our Discord and ask in the Masamod channel. Sky Rising already said it. Disable fast render and shaders. And render regions.
Not helping today, Buffets?
Maybe in a bit. I have to go to the gas station in a minute. What is your favorite beacon effect? I guess that's probably haste for everyone.
They're all quite good.
Imagine not having instant mining.
The only one...
What would you rather sacrifice? Turn the question around.
Yeah.
So, pretty sure at that point it's haste.
Then I would get rid of, I think, protection.
Resistance, you mean?
Or resistance, yeah. Or strength. We also never need that, really.
Resistance is actually quite good as well. I would get rid of jump boost 100%.
I think resistance, you can't get that otherwise, no potion for it, right?
Yeah.
So, that should...
No, you can Turtle Master potion.
Yeah.
And not Shepples.
No, we're not whitelisted on the Hermitcraft server. This was also not recorded on the actual server, you just got a copy. Yeah, the bot's also not real.
What? Mango?
Sorry to burst your bubble.
Mango breaking the fourth dimension. Can't actually leak that stuff, Mango. prayer. One diagonal slime block is from Tweakaroo's offset placement, I think.
Yep.
It's where you get the little GUI on the blocks where you can decide on which side diagonally you want to place it, or one block away.
Slime.
The quarry blows the blocks up to collect them. Pushing them in front of a player would be super slow, and it would also be fairly unreliable.
Yeah, pushing it in front of a player is a problem, because there's no universal tool. I'm gonna break the dirt quite slow, for example, if you have a pickaxe.
You would also need a system to slow the quarry down, depending if there's still blocks to mine or not.
Yeah.
So if you get like a lot of logs in a row, then the quarry needs to stop and say like, hey, waiting for player, would be probably a lot more complicated to actually build it.
Yeah.
The gigantic block conveyors, which are super laggy as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's definitely possible to do something like that, but nobody on our server really has intention to do that. It's just like the second or third best way to do it, so yeah.
Yeah, you can't fortune it, but you can easily mine 2.5 times the area. And then you basically get the same amount as if you fortune it for, like for example, diamonds. Yeah, we were just making fun of Nightbot trying to flag your comment. Medication is not offensive. Unless you're Nightbot, then medication is super offensive.
I think the chest drop was the offensive part.
Yeah.
Oh, we make mistakes all the time. Just not shown in the video.
Yeah. No, it's like always flawless.
Never build a dark oak for a spruce tree farm in the wrong orientation. Never.
Never. Don't think you can RNG manipulate machines to give you fortune drops. That's not how it works. Like, fortune is, I think, player RNG. So, that only affects player-based stuff.
Thanks so much, Voltaire, for the 13 months already.
How does it deal with lava? So before the quarry grabs blocks, it tries to push them forward. Therefore you always have a 12 block thick shield in front of the quarry, which basically just crushes every liquid. Oh, it's world RNG, but you need the fortune effect. Okay, yeah. No fortune TNT. RIP.
Can I use lazy looting by holding a pick? There were some versions where I could do that. Not
probably
anymore, right?
Yeah.
Hmm?
I don't know for the future. But yeah, you could.
Wasn't it fixed?
I don't know in the future. But in 1.12, sure, but you would also need to hand place every piece of TNT. So.
I think we will need like 25 hours more to finish this. Or 20 hours. Yeah, definitely made good progress in 4 days.
No, the lava would not be a big deal in the Nether for the quarry. Need a different item collection though. Oh, so Sky just answered the question, it doesn't work.
Yeah, but remember, at some point you could have your pickaxe in your offhand forged and kill him with a bow or whatever.
In the snapshots.
Yeah, yeah.
In the snapshots, there was a bug. Make a movable minecart collection system in the Nether. We did it for the 1000x1000 quarry in the Nether.
Hey, yo.
Hey, Doc.
Hey, Doc. We're streaming, by the way.
Yeah, so. What the heck did Miles draw? Miles, that your face, that the emote. What?
It's epic, right?
Yeah.
So the squirrel is some frog emote.
Yeah. The pepper hands.
Yeah.
You know, the crying. Like, not again! It's like awesome.
Nice. Did you watch it, Methods?
Yeah, of course.
Did you like it?
Yeah, it was good.
The scene, that flowed nicely.
Yeah, we also advertised your Hermitcraft episode already here.
Yay! Yeah. That was crazy carpet. Nice demonstration for carpet. Maybe we should do a behind the scenes video and promote carpet via it a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it would be maybe nice. Everybody should use carpet.
So why is Hermitcraft not using it?
We're doing.
Oh, you actually did?
Okay. We have a special carpet version Nemon made for them that just removes anti-cheat because it's completely useless and ruins your day.
Mm-hmm.
And actually doesn't stop no one from cheating either, so.
Everybody thinks you're joining Hermitcraft, Mango.
Yeah.
Reading the comments is like, oh my god, Mango for season 7 confirmed.
You should actually, like, I don't know, write some bot that makes fake accounts on YouTube that just spams the Hermitcraft members' comment section that they should join SciCraft.
Yeah.
Get him back. Oh my god, you should join SciCraft in season 2.
Actually spam methods for Hermitcraft. I would watch that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I would do it.
Oh, really?
Redstone Police. Storyline.
And here it started, the great war between Hermitcraft and SciCraft. The war for methods.
Yeah. And I already know who's winning it too.
We got the money.
Yeah, maybe for season 7, I can get Doc to form the Redstone Police.
need an extra skin for that. It's the redstone Nazis. What are we doing here?
This is probably not a good idea, Doc. I'm not sure if you should do that. I suggested the police, man. It would kind of be funny to have like you and maybe Ifo run around and like give people fees for ugly and not nice and clean redstone.
Laugh at people just constantly, you know.
No, no, you have to be like super. You have to be like super serious about it. There's fees and everything. Like,
no, you just stand there and be like,
unnecessary redstone dust. That's gonna be like 4 diamonds.
Lisa is already a Hermitcraft member.
Yeah, the lag on the Hermitcraft server. We recorded the video, like, pretty much everywhere you go, it's like 48 MSPT without doing anything.
I'm not sure if it maybe was the hundreds of armor stands or what. I don't know. It's definitely noticeable.
Yeah, the issue is though with the redstone police charging people for diamonds. The redstone is not nice and clean, and whenever Doc does something himself, he would also have to pay it. His ghetto wiring.
I'm quite sure the world download will come out within a week. But I don't know exactly when.
Really want to see how big it is again. Doc, do you know? Yeah, well, we have it, right? How big was it?
The world download?
Yeah.
It was just the overworld. A couple of gigabytes.
How much? How much?
Was it 5 or 6?
Well, it's actually surprisingly low for that many people.
Okay, now it's just building instant repeaters.
Who finances SciCraft? That would be Notch. He saw our amazing content and ever since then. RNG doesn't really work in 13 plus.
I play video games for a living.
Best job ever. I don't know. Mango just said a little bit ago that he's probably spends like 40 to 70 hours a week doing it, so
yeah.
It's definitely better jobs that earn you more money.
Mm-hmm. Thanks a lot, Daddy Rim. But I like it, it's fun. There's definitely also jobs that you just hate doing. It's definitely not the case for me.
I just recently stopped working on the leaf farm for today because I got triggered. But the single one is finished. I might make even a video about it for 115, 116 leaf farms.
How much is it?
10,000 leaves 10, per hour.
Sweet.
Just as fast as Red Ration's RNG one.
What about those extra saplings? Yeah, what happened with those? What was it?
I'm still getting them.
Did you ever figure out what's causing it?
Nope. Also, I haven't spent too much time on it, but maybe if I'm getting super bored at some point, I'm doing it. Nope. It's allowed to repeat your question, but if we didn't answer them, chances are we didn't want to. When are the beastie iron farms coming? 4140, you know what?
It's just a matter of scaling it up.
Yeah.
Watch then tutorial you can just take for small iron Doc's farm,
iron farm it 100 times. It 100 times.
Yeah. That's pretty much it. I wonder if I can just walk here. Pull it from there. Yeah, slime walking, no. It's not better.
Heavily depends how you define the best iron farm. What is the best one?
They're all the same though.
Yeah.
They're definitely a lot less interesting. Yep. In 114, it's pretty much one design, and there's not much you can be creative with.
Yeah, if you want it bigger, you just build the same farm again, Olix 2K. There's no, like, here's how you do the same farm with more villagers and make more. No, you just build it again. You might use some portals to build them closer to each other without interfering.
The only thing you can do, you can use a pillager to scare them instead of a different mob with a higher range. But yeah, so boring. Devs changed something about villager brains. Oh yeah. Don't think it will affect iron farms though.
Yeah.
Is it hard to play Mob 12 and make videos in the latest version? Not sure if I get the question. So, you mean if it's hard to switch between versions that often? Not get confused? No.
I think it's actually good, it's something different.
Yep.
You still keep up with the changes and what's coming and what's new for the future.
Yeah, in November I played a mod pack. On stream even. Played Terraformapunk for 2.5 weeks approximately. Spent actually a lot of time on it. Probably spent over 100 hours playing it. Got even further in the progression than ESO did. In a series that is running for a year.
So this was almost 7 days to die level or what?
Yeah. No lifing it. But it was really fun and addictive in the start. No. XCOM was also playing it a lot.
No, that's vanilla for you. Your controls get reset every single time.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a workaround though.
Multi-MC, but I don't like that.
Yeah, I don't like it.
No, I can only say that we now try to get ready to update to 1.16, but that will be a longer process. In the next SciCraft episode, I will present a kind of roadmap, what we need to do to inform you. So there's a couple of farms we still need to make, because that wouldn't be possible anymore in a couple of projects. We want to finish in this this version. And we're probably gonna update, yeah, probably late this year. So it will take a while to finish all of that.
Or late, or even later.
Or even next year, yeah.
Did technical Minecraft players use law of physics? The physics laws of Minecraft we use all the time. Since we don't have, like,
I guess those laws
IRL physics
in the game code.
Yeah.
None of them. I mean, we don't have real life physics law is applied in a video game. So yeah. Algorithms. You know, just approximations.
How far will we have to go in the Nether to get the new terrain? Well, probably 1,000 couple blocks. Depends on which direction and where.
What about gravity? Well, there's formulas for that, but the algorithm works a bit different.
Yeah.
In real life, it doesn't just add to the velocity value every tick.
Also, IRL gravity applies to, like, pretty much everything. And not just sand and anvils and dragon eggs. It's a shame that it's such a long delay for all the various add-ons to get updated. What add-ons? I mean, if you use fabric mods, then the chances are it's getting updated really quick.
Oh. Working on a quarry. If you aren't working on the leaf farm, what are you doing in methods? That's what I want to know. But yeah, it's reading chat. It's helpful there. I think he said he's going to the gas station.
No, I'm still here. Licking my wounds and being sad about my sore body.
Thanks, Kim, for the sub.
If you ever get bored of Minecraft, what do you do? Stop being bored of Minecraft. Yeah. Play some more until it's gone.
I mean, it's could ask the same question. If you ever get bored of your job, what are you gonna do? Either get a new job or just continue with your job. Thanks for the 100 bits, 101 bits, Dad P. Thanks a lot.
I think the chat interaction is also largely based on the community we have, because if you look in other communities, you often get a lot of stupid questions, repeating questions, and like in SciCraft streams, it's mostly like actually interesting stuff or valuable questions, which is a lot more fun to answer than 100 times the same question or like things like that.
Since I don't have 1.12 in the title anymore, nobody even asks why we're still playing 1.12 anymore. This is good.
Why though?
Yeah.
No, you can always ask. It's never bad to ask a dumb question. It's just, if you look at like, wait, let me find a good example. You know, if you, for example, look at a Hermitcraft stream and there's hundreds of questions, when are you going to update, when are you going to update, and that's all the people ask, or like nothing interesting is ever being like brought up, then it's not as fun to also interact with your chat. It wasn't meant as shade, it was just an example I more or less made up. Could have used someone else as well, but I don't actually watch a lot of streams.
Probably gonna update straight away to 116. I'm not really interested in getting, for example, the better armor in 114 or something like that. I don't think we need that. Is there anything you want, Methods?
OP armor.
Really?
It's probably some version we want to update to do something. I would say we'd update straight to 116. If we find something, we...
It's not even that OP, I mean...
It's actually the
Netherite armor, in a lot of cases, is already better.
Yeah, but they should fix that bug that their chance get lost, right? Mm. And then, like, you can have super OP Netherite armor.
Oh yeah, one OP piece is really worth it. So you have, like, let's say you have normal helmet and normal... boots, then have OP leggings, that's really helpful. We have everything on it. So, protection, blast protection, fire, and everything on just one piece. Literally every single one piece. That's really good. That's the best, yeah. Yeah, maybe we should get that.
Maybe there's also some other interesting stuff we have to ask all the members and think about it for some time.
Hmm.
But I mean, I'm definitely not against abusing the system a little bit in that regard. You know, if it's a full release and not a snapshot, then it's actually Mojang's mess up and not us abusing anything.
Use for the diamond pants? Yeah, but now it's gonna actually be harder to put stuff on it. You actually have to plan it out, getting like 9 enchantments on him. So we would need to craft a lot of new diamond pants, but we can also buy them from the villagers.
Freaking Oreo, you literally made 10,000. You used 10,000 diamonds,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
What the crap? What is SciCraft's view on Duke glitches? We would love to not use any of them. Unfortunately, there's a few items Mojang refuses to automate, which are so good that we really want them, and therefore we have to duke them. Like, for example, Schalke shells and Elytras.
Yeah, many streaming 10 minutes. You can also raid many after my stream.
I mean, usually it's just much more fun to build a proper farm for something instead of using some dupe exploit to get what you want to do. I mean.
Why would you use more than 2 Elytras? Because I don't want to go back and repair them all the time. So yeah. I usually have 10 on me. And then people also lose them somehow.
Francescoing them?
Yeah. So on a server like we have, we at least need a couple hundred Elytra.
Having dispensers placing blocks would be an absolute game changer, redstone wise.
At least for us, I mean, this is mostly useful for large scale projects. Like
building... Oh, it will also be super interesting for more casual people.
Can make probably make fun contraptions and whatnot.
Yeah. You think Mumbo and some people like that wouldn't go absolutely ham on that feature? Like, for sure.
Mumbo probably would make a bunker and a piston base. Yeah.
Hey, it's still technical. Yeah, of course you can use mods or plugins, but kind of want to stay a bit vanilla. We have all of that in carpet mod, but we don't want to really use it on the survival server. Obviously, you can always mod everything into the game that you like, but...
I think it's too easy to have dispenser placing blocks. Why is it too easy? What makes it too easy? We have it actually on Skyblock.
Yeah.
Doesn't make a lot of stuff easier. Just gets rid of some repetitive grind.
Yeah.
But it doesn't make any contraptions easier, I would say.
It's definitely easier to hold right click with a program or with the... a reload texture pack trick than placing a dispenser and powering it in the correct time interval.
Definitely allows for extra complexity and really...
content!
Content, extra
gameplay.
Content.
A lot of gameplay added by it.
What it gets rid of is just boring grind.
Hello.
Hi, folks.
This quarry is actually the intended way to play, yeah.
Would you consider making universal tree farm with a TNT blast gem? No, a wizard cage instead of a TNT blast gem. You can just put it in a wizard cage as well. Put everything in a one by block stream, and then that's easily... adjustable for wizard cage. I can actually also do that. Make a quick video about it. Yeah.
Yeah, block placer should definitely be endgame. I had suggested that it's crafted like a dispenser, but instead of a bow, you use a netherite ingot. And bottoms, you can't spam thousands of them. So, I think that would be totally fair. Could use other items as well, for example, like the nether star is used for like nothing besides the beacon. Plenty of expensive items you could use to balance something.
It's actually funny that the beacon is cheaper than the netherite block now. making a beacon. Should actually do it the other way. Place a lot of beacons and then a netherite block on top.
Then it gets you the negative effect beacon that Cup wanted. Yeah, I would also be fine with a netherite block to craft a block placer. I wouldn't mind. Oof. Be hard to get, but... would be a challenge.
Yeah, this would be a very restrictive then.
Yeah, and? Yeah, you have to really think, like, do you need it here? Are you sure you really need it here? And then, okay, I am spending this thing.
Would this already be a case where we say, hey, this is so useful, we should just stupid it, because it's impossible to get.
No.
No? Like with the Schalke box?
We can TNT it.
Anyway, I think there's not even a good dupe bug 116 right now anyway, so...
update suppression.
Still works?
Okay. Yeah. Sky fixed it.
Terraforming question. Won't destroy an island, have an ocean in its place. Destroying the island of TNT was easy, but now it's a hole in the water. What's the best way to fill it with water? I would place blocks on like the second layer below the water surface, and then just place water on top and let it flow down. You don't need sources all the way.
But it still looks crappy.
Why?
Because you can see that.
That it flows down?
Yeah.
Why?
I think you can see it.
I don't think it makes a difference.
Well, it's about looks, right?
You could try it out real quick.
I think you could actually make some waterproof flying machines that start from the bottom, fly over, so it can all reform.
Plus kelp. Oh, kelp is a good idea.
Yeah, kelp.
Yeah. Kelp is a good idea.
Yeah.
Because that makes water sources, and just place kelp on. Yeah, remove it again. But I'm quite sure, let's spam some TNT here on that island.
What's the most useless item slash block in Minecraft with considering decor and purpose? Oof. Quite sure. There's a bunch.
Yeah, should be enough. So what I would do is then fill this layer up.
Isn't it one too low?
No, that would work. Oh, that was one too low, yeah. Then forms water sources on top. And then you removed it again. Looks good to me. Yeah.
Yeah, true, you can't actually tell. No.
Yeah, that's what I would do.
Can't you also craft a stone to diorite using quartz? I think that's probably one of the most useless things in the game.
Quartz is renewable now.
Well, yeah, true.
Nobody was talking about diorite being renewable now.
Right? Yeah.
Nobody.
Clickbait title, it's coming. Fully automatic diorite farm. I don't hate diorite. I just always found it super funny when people started calling it dirt poop, because it literally just looks like that. Bird poop. Yeah, granite is actually horrible. I really dislike granite too.
The polished variant is okay, but the normal granite is awful.
With block blazers, could you build quarries, given that they're made of repeating elements? Yeah, for sure, but you would also need to build a bigger machine to actually move the block blazers around. And then you need another machine to build that machine.
Don't think and it would be worth it.
Generated an infinite loop of building machines that build machines to build machines to build machines to build machines. It's not worth.
I like that instant line here where I do the same over and over again. We can definitely make some kind of flying machine with a movable block placer that would do it at first, but is it worth it? Build a... I don't know, it's gonna be quite complex, the machine. For 288 blocks. Some cases does it's worth it.
Does anyone know a farm for wither skellies without much redstone? Like only the wither roses and golems? Yeah, logical geek boys. But if you're making a perimeter, which probably includes removing over 5 million blocks, then you probably want to use redstone and the best possible farm you can build.
Yeah, it's really pointless to make a simple wizard skeleton farm if all the effort is into preparing the area anyway. Then you might as well spend an hour more and build a proper farm.
Yeah.
If you already spent 50 hours on just preparing the area for it.
Yeah. If you don't prepare the area and you're good with getting like one skull per hour, then go for the Wither Rose farm.
God dang it, I'm terrible at flying today. Come on. Also, I'm getting a bit lag connections in the past. Oh, thanks a lot for the 300 bits, Klößen. Nice performance from Methods. Yeah. He spent forever yesterday setting up the command blocks. More work than it looks like.
Oh yeah.
And of course, we did this on a not on the actual Hermitcraft server. So they don't allow command blocks there, of course. Or do they? I don't know. Because that was a separate world.
It's the same world on a different server. Mm. I was wondering if you have a better, newer, dispensaless overworld mob farm than the one you showed in November 2018.
What?
Oh, dispensaless overworld mob farm. I don't think much changed in that regard.
There's much. No, nothing new got added would make it better. No, still up to date.
I'm surprised people still haven't figured out that Doc M isn't real at all and we did at all. We're just using Doc as a... how's it called? Got my train of thought.
Yeah, yes, full control. Make a jump. Oh, it's not in survival.
Oh, it's cheating again, as usual. Also, the infinity portal, it just leads into our SciCraft secret layer, where we plan all and everything.
I've got piston? I think I took a box. No! True. Some have got to pick up the tracker box again. Ah, thanks again, Klößen, for another 100 bits. And I forgot to place a piston? Okay. I'll fix it as well.
Impulse is a hermit, Skizzleman isn't. As far as I know. And Nightbot flagging XCOM's video. Yeah, so you can replace portal blocks with liquids, like for example lava or water. And if you update suppress the placement of the liquid, it only destroys one portal block, and that's how you can make the infinity portal.
Yeah, we're working on a quarry. Oh, somebody's starting on top. Let's check it out.
Tuno is
working on a yeah, machine.
See, perfect. It's a machine to do something on the quarry. Yeah. It's gonna build the roof.
Does this work already?
Probably not. Oh, he uses it. Is it using the three-way placer? No. Or maybe it is.
Hmm.
Are you able to remove villagers' profession after trading with them? No. At least not in any intended way, or any way I know about.
How long does it take you to come up with stuff? To know how long did you work on the quarry?
A few hundred hours.
A few hundred hours.
Probably less than 1,000.
No, but that doesn't consider all the development that has been done before. So like conceptual development and stuff takes years.
I was actually rather quickly with my quarry. Only took 75 hours.
Do you also have connection issues all the time?
Yeah, I do. Not sure what it could be. Somebody increased the bat switch. We have 633 bats now. Not sure if that's really necessary. We could easily just have 200. I'm not sure it was a good idea to have so many bats. Maybe we have to reduce that number at some point. But yeah. Also in 116 we can't have a batted squid switch anymore.
I think Mango showed his playtime in the last stream and it was 1.09 years.
Yeah, yeah.
Was someone chat asking?
1.09 years still. Time since last death, 2 days. But I had 12 days before and then Rego killed me. What do I think of phantoms? I'm glad that they're not in 112.
Sky rats. I wonder if they fixed the bugs that I showed with them. Otherwise, I'm definitely forcing Doc to make a mean phantom trap in the next Hermit Craft season.
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah,
for a while you've been developing some traps with all kinds of mobs. Wasn't phantoms also one of... Yeah,
the phantoms, so they spawn in and they track the player, right? So they spawn in depending on your location and they also remember that location, and then you send them to the Nether and they still try to go to those coordinates. So you can like just send them into the Nether, you build your overworld phantom farm on the Nether coordinates of someone else's portal, and then you just keep sending phantoms in there. When they load the area, there's like hundreds of phantoms coming for them because they all fly there. It's so dumb.
What is this accent? Hessisch.
Mine?
Yeah.
In English?
What's that in English, actually? You know?
Hessian.
Hessian.
Like the saying, alle Hesse sind Verbrecher, denn sie klauen Aschebecher. Yeah, the curse of binding is a thing on the SciCraft server. It's definitely dangerous to go AFK. It also explains why we're always short on diamond helmets.
Most of the time I actually just use a portal pigment farm because that runs while the mob switch is on. It's quite convenient. And it's around, what was it, 80,000 XP per hour? Bit better than Enderman farm, but you don't need to worry about killing the Enderman
yourself.
Completely
hands-free, fully AFK, don't have to throw any potions. But we also have a max XP guardian farm. In fact, we have a guardian farm that can like supply a lot of players with max XP.
We also have a max XP pigment farm.
Yep.
We have an enderman farm for XP. Do you wanna use that? Get some pearls as well. Is it the expert version pigment farm? It's actually a different concept using llamas. Yeah, it's even faster than that. The mobs are not angry at the they're angry at a Yama. Why do you guys run out of diamond armors? What?
Dying in lava, dying in the void, not retrieving your stuff and despawning it, and of course, Curse of Binding, pumpkins need helmets to be broken. How many server days have passed?
131,829.
We don't have villagers to buy it from, it's 112. The best way to get Wither Skeleton Skulls is a Wither Skeleton Skull farm.
Yeah, juke boxes also need diamonds.
Yep, enchanting tables.
Actually, I also want to still make a lot of diamond armor, but now that we have Netherite, I'm just probably gonna delay it. I actually prefer having thorns and everything.
Why the thorns? I hate it.
I like it. I don't know, just like it. Want it on every
Tab likes it.
At least you stopped making the AFK being hit by a zombie excuse.
Isn't there some farms that screws things up, though?
What's so bad about swans? What's the downside?
Just wait for 1:13 when they edit the stupid sound.
I know that sound. No, swans are good.
Can you tell us a Minecraft fact that most people don't know? We certainly can. Just have to actually, like, decide for one.
And?
Did you know that you could instant mine vines with an axe because it's the proper tool to mine vines, but they don't drop anything?
Not even Silk Touch Axe.
Nope.
Now you have to come up with a random Minecraft fact, Mango.
Oh my god. That's a good one. Did you know that Yamas can have different strength values, and depending on those, wolves are scared or not.
Strength 5 Yama. Oh god, I'm getting... help.
Did you know that at one point in time, at 000 on the map, there was a log?
Yeah. Making a hole to the void, an oak log.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What happened to ours? Did we have one?
No.
Okay. I forgot what update it was removed. I'm not sure it was a bug, Golden. I think they put it in there on purpose. That way they'd be able to recognize where it was. Where 000
was. I'm pretty sure that wasn't
put in
on purpose, considering that it was fixed.
Mm.
Mad culture. That's when you know you got a good random fact. If people question if it's actually a thing. Yeah, it's actually a thing with the strength value.
It's actually true. I actually made a big Yama breeding strength camp. It took like hundreds of Yamas to get it.
Yeah,
is that the one at the Yama Vader?
No.
Aww.
Another benefit of strength 5 Yamas is that if you put a chest inventory on them, they have additional inventory spaces. So we have now strength 5 Yamas, we can always get them with 15 inventory slots now if you breed a new one.
Holy cow, how much work did Iceberg or somebody put in last night?
I think Sky was also helping, but Iceberg has been doing a lot of work as well. So the Yamas can have different strength values from 1 to 5. There's a small chance that a wild Yama has strength 5, but usually you get the weaker ones. And if you breed them, there's a certain chance to get a stronger one each time. So usually, I think we started with a strength 2 Yama, bred it 50 times, test it, see if you get a stronger one, and then use that. And so on. I think we were the first people that ever bred a Yama in Minecraft.
Yep.
Because we found so many bugs with it that nobody reported before. It was crazy. This was after a year or so they were already in the game or so.
Yep. I'm pretty sure no one ever like used Yamas until now either. I mean, people don't know that they have different amounts of inventory slots.
Yeah, all the animals get added over time. They're a really good source of random facts.
Yeah.
Like, who knows the turtles pathfind to where they're born? You could put them 10,000 blocks away and somebody would pathfind back again. No, we have no intention to go to the world border. It's kind of a nice challenge, but it's so pointless, and there's a lot of downsides to doing that, actually.
I'm thinking about another totally random Minecraft fact.
Kupfin a while ago made videos about it, which were super popular for millions of views, random Minecraft facts. There were some good ones in there. Didn't know I had to roleplay. So we just set up some bots.
Weren't asked at all. Actually, like, I asked Stock to do it. The whole AI part was my idea. Random fact, magma emits light but only level 3, so it makes no difference in spawning. Random fact, light level 3 does make a difference in spawning. So everything that's above light level 0 actually does affect how fast mobs are spawning. Get random facted on. I think they fixed the bug where magma blocks remember the light level thingy, which was kind of
sure?
a nice behavior.
I think it's just still bugged. At least it was when we played 114.
I think it removes it when you reload the world or something. It's not really reliable or usable, which is kind of sad.
So I'm not sure if it's still in there, but it was always bugged and never reliable, unfortunately. Mm.
Would have been nice if they added it as an intentional feature.
I think Iso at some point was actually using it in his Let's Play, but he also figured out it doesn't last. I just removed 114 for. Okay, thanks, Noodle. No, I don't have all the advancements. I had all the achievements. But I can't get all the advancements anyway, so I don't care at all, because I would need to defeat the Ender Dragon, and that's something we really don't want to do.
Yep.
Because we mined all the obsidian pillars by hand. Took us 20 hours to do that. Really don't want to do that again.
I have another awesome random fact. Corals aren't movable, but dead corals are.
Thanks, Owen, for the sub. Yeah, good that dead corals somehow are made movable. It's like almost they wanted us to have TNT duping back, but we would have known another way already, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, the coral is definitely better than the top server for that.
The Yama breeding bug has already have a carpet mod fix. And I'm pretty sure it's the same fix that made it into vanilla. In future versions.
Yes, it is a mining machine.
500 viewers today, Mango. Did you get raided? No, right?
I don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
It's actually usual numbers I have when we do like a marathon stream. Yeah, I'm sure what's going on.
It's me with the random Minecraft facts. Yeah.
You've also been streaming consistently for the last few days, around the same time for the last few days,
too. Yeah, probably that. But before that, I didn't stream for 2 weeks.
Also, it's Sunday, it's the weekend.
Dog's video? True.
I'd like to believe that it's the random Minecraft facts.
Dead bushes are 10 times more likely to generate in a...
Yeah!
in a mesa biome than in the desert.
Yep, so if you need dead bushes, go to the mesa. That is so random. I was so confused when I noticed that.
I'm trying to think of the other random facts I know. My brain's still not all functioning. I did manage to adult today, though, so that's important.
Yeah, and she has to get the dead bushes.
Yep.
It's also something that is not renewable in vanilla.
She is? Oh, dead bushes.
The dead bushes.
Why not both?
No, zero functionality.
No, you can crush them for sticks.
Oh yeah. Great source of sticks.
Yep, great source of bones, iron helmets and XP. I wonder if the wiki still says that, let me check.
Yeah, we do have more than a double chest of Deadbush, by the way.
Yeah, that's how I found out that they're 10 times more likely in the Mesa.
Be careful saying that. Manny will put all the dead bushes in his village.
We actually do have a mechanic on the Patreon server to get dead bushes. I would actually like to see that in vanilla as well. So if you place a sapling in a desert biome, there is a chance if it gets random to the sapling, that it would turn into a dead bush. I think it's really nice.
There also has to be no water around in
the night. No water around, yeah, so it's not getting hydrated. Oh, thanks a lot to Owen for the 200 bits. Modded ex... Wait, question mark? No, it's not modded. This is... Well, technically it's modded because we use a carpet mod. But this is, yeah, vanilla, more or less. Really close to vanilla.
It's more vanilla than paper or spigot or any of that, so... The carpet mod's more of an analytical tool and bug fix type thing. It doesn't change any of the core game mechanics.
Oh, they removed the great source of bones, iron helmet, and XP.
No.
Probably made too much fun of it.
Methods, this is why we can't have nice things. You make fun of them.
Okay, I think I'm gonna build one more row of those repeater or instant lines there, then call it a day. Yeah, gonna stream tomorrow again. Quite sure. We can maybe finish it tomorrow, if not day after that. Oh yeah, we can also not check out what Tuno is up to, the top of the roof building. So he's trying.
Oh, yeah, it's running.
He's trying to automate the process of building the roof somehow. Not sure. Successful.
How is this working even?
I think he makes a block conveyor, but how does he push him over then? Or does he just move every single block over? I don't know. I think he actually moves over the block placing part. But how does he move the conveyor over? I don't know.
Maybe with a three-directional fly? It looks like a three-directional flying machine.
Oh, he launches one. Oh, there we go.
When a roll is finished.
It's happening. Yeah, let's watch that.
Yeah, there it goes.
Yeah, pushes everything over. Then he places the next row of blocks.
Nice.
And then he logs out and joins back.
Oh, we got 500 bits from Owen. Are you in Hermitcraft Season 7? I am not.
Oh, I've seen so many people asking that. Mango, when are you going to give in and just join Hermitcraft?
It's not up to me. Nice.
Yeah, it's a nice unconventional way of doing it. I like it.
Mm-hmm.
It's also a whole lot less leggy than moving all the blocks over.
Yeah.
Is there anything piglins are attracted to at all, even? Yeah, any gold item besides rails, clocks, and some other stuff.
Yep.
Any gold item except for rails, clocks, some other stuff.
That's getting fixed. Also in progress by Henrik.
Okay.
So literally anything that has gold inside will work. Also like Netherite.
I don't know about that one, but I'm waiting for him to fix it all and then I'm reporting the Netherite.
The next patch.
I'm just imagining them running around the pocket watch.
Is that an Ocarina of Time Navi?
Hey, listen!
Yeah.
I used to have that as a soundbite on my stream that only mods could post when they really needed my attention when I was distracted.
So like all the time?
There were times where it got used quite a bit. There are times where it also got used when it didn't need to just to be silly, so.
Oh, it's ZFG. Also watch him sometimes.
ZFG is fun to watch. He's been working on a lot of Majora's Mask lately, if I remember correctly.
They found some exploit where they can do arbitrary code execution?
Arbitrary code execution. CE, ACE, or whatever, I think. It worked for Oot, so I think they're moving it to Majora's Mask now. It's been interesting to watch.
Outline mod is Light Medica.
Think of it as a schematic. That way you don't have to switch between monitors when working on or tabs even when working on projects. It gives you a layout right there on the screen, so you minimize your the amount of time you're looking at another screen or something to
which do also your project. Is not fun at all.
No.
This gives you a sense of pride and accomplishment, though.
Also reduces mistakes by a lot.
Imagine using currency at all. Imagine not having a communistic technical Minecraft server.
It's rough. People are like, hey, I'll sell you this for 5 diamonds, and then you play technical Minecraft and you have all the diamonds. And then you go through all the shops and buy all the things, and people get pissed off. That's the great part. People get upset when you buy all the things at all the shops. You're like, oh, hey, I'll just take all of this and all that so I don't have to work for it. And then they can't go in and buy shit. They actually have to work for it.
How far would you think the server would be without Light Medica? Just as far.
It just would have taken more time to build a lot of this stuff.
Communism works really well in Minecraft.
Could also work in large scale if
well power executed, didn't corrupt.
If well executed, yeah.
Power tends to accumulate. That's the bad part. SciCraft is a type 3 civilization.
What is that?
You're not. I have to Google it to know what it is, to be able to say it for sure without misquoting. Oh. Well, it's the Kardavashi scale, and
I think it just works because we have so much stuff that. What's the point of wanting to hug it for yourself? Like, even on public servers, when I build farms, I usually open them up for everyone, because do I need 300,000 slime per hour? No. Why would I charge people to use it? I don't know.
Anyway, to keep Pikmin spawning, but stop Piklin.
Mid scale.
Magma blocks. Piglins can't spawn on magma blocks.
Yep.
That's about ready to say the one scale. We're not like international travelers that harness the power of a sun to travel from solar system to solar system. So, like, yeah, it's a different scale, and I'm breaking blocks, and I'm distracted by stone at the moment, so.
How many quarries have you built in total now on SciCraft? Oof. You built first one in the Nether?
No, the first one was the Mesa Quarry.
No, the very first Mesa Quarry, the horizontal one.
Oh, true, the very first one, Coolman Quarry, in the 100 by 100 in the Mesa.
Yeah.
That's one. Then we built the one in the Nether, 300 by 300.
Yep.
Then we built another Pellas? One in the Nether,
Pella?
1000 by 1000. Yep. Then we built the big Mesa Quarry.
Yep.
And now this one, so 5.
5.
Well, technically this one is 2, so 6.
Yes.
But yeah, technically it's also just one split in two. I guess we count it as one, since otherwise it would be a bit small.
I think there's a world download somewhere in the SciCraft Discord.
For this one?
Yeah.
Yep.
I love the word of Nibin and Nibon in some of his farms where he doesn't explain. It's just like, I'm not providing a world download, because if you can't figure this out, then you have no need to be doing it because you're not going to be able to do it correctly.
Like, is it better to use minecarts or flying machines in my mob farm to collect the items? I would probably say minecarts because item lag is a thing in 113 plus, super laggy. And flying machines most likely block spawning spaces while collecting the items, while the minecarts you can run underneath without interfering with the farm.
You always tell when no to finish the row. He logs out and back in. Cool.
How much is left? Need to build a couple more of those instant lines. Then the rest of those flying machines need to be built here, so that part. And then the roof. It's not that much. So I think maybe 20% is left.
It'll be done in the next 2-3 days.
Maybe tomorrow. Maybe. Maybe the day after that. But yeah. Definitely, our goal was to build the whole quarry in 7 days, and today's day 5 of building it. Looks good.
How long did it take us to do the first iteration?
I think it was 5 days.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm. How do the instant lines work? Will the pistons, or if you depower them, they retract instantly. So this redstone block is moved away. This piston retracts instantly, and if you follow it, this line, there's another redstone block. And then the next piston retracts instantly. Just a chain. Yeah, we'll run for maybe 10 days to cover the full distance.
So long as nobody stops it.
Yeah.
But we want to get the area there finished, so I think stopping it right now would be silly unless it's to work on other things that are going to be in the area there. I think we should just let it run and finish and then worry about doing other stuff later, but that's my opinion. Work on things that don't need TPS.
How does this work with the ocean? If the flying machine goes up, it always pushes blocks, or tries to push blocks forward. That removes all the liquid in front of it.
The only thing that breaks it with an ocean is if as it picks up too much gravel or something, and then that falls down and can open a gap in the 12 wide wall that sometimes can cause a hole to peek through.
Yeah, just gonna finish
which
this
is rare.
Just gonna finish this line here, then we can fly over to the first quarry we finished a while ago and check out the full thing, also with the block shield in front.
That block shield is one of my favorite things in the quarries because sometimes they'll run over villages and you can get villagers trapped in their houses that wind up getting smushed. Freaking brilliant, I love it.
Do you think Mojang will change the Piglin dropping OP amounts of Porkchop?
It's the Hoglin.
Yeah. Also, I don't think the amount is OP, it's the amount of Hoglins. I don't know. I don't think they will fix it.
Also, I don't think they're gonna change it.
Yeah.
They're not expecting too many people to go to streams, typically. They tend to think of the casual player first.
Doesn't matter. Just gonna call it a day. Okay, let's fly over to the other quarry. We're gonna build a crafting system for the TNT in there. Because behind this wall we have our creeper farm. This is gunpowder. It's just empty. We'll map out. So the plan is to produce gunpowder here. We have a sand, a sand duper, a sand farm all over the server, and all the sand goes to spawn. So basically just need to bring all the sand here and then we can put that together into TNT. That's a creeper farm, by the way. Yeah, we built it last year mostly. Here's also the map art. We can see the whole perimeter. Yep, quarry area is dead. Mesa is getting mined away. How do you remove the obsidian around the portal? The technique is called update suppression.
See, we even have bigger infinity portals than Hermitcraft.
Also, yeah.
All the bedrock, so we can summon bigger people to
all the bedrock got removed there, so the farm is built as low as possible. Just gonna check my lighter real quick, and I have 5 rockets left. Good. Okay, let's get some rockets on the fly to the quarry. By the uneven shape of the perimeter, well, you've seen the map board, just... Yeah, so it resembles the creeper picture. Yeah, this is all vanilla. Can do it in vanilla. But this was a lot of work, a lot of hours went into this. The walls, by the way, they were the blocks were hand placed, but they were brought with a conveyor belt in position. So we had a stationary player and some dispensers supplying a player with the blocks, and then conveyor belt machines pushed them all over the place.
Pushed them down.
Yeah, it's always weird to have strange terrain, the normal terrain again, and now we've got the huge hole of the quarry.
I like it.
The perimeter is, for looks, that big, I think.
Yep. So we needed emerald ore, so we took down a bit more of the extremist biome. So yeah, here in front you can see the block shield, so the quarry always tries to push blocks forward. Which in case of gravel and sand is a bit of an issue, because that stuff falls down. But yeah. So if there's any liquid in front, then the blocks that get pushed forward, just take it out. That's how it could, yeah, how it can go through an ocean. Oh, thanks a lot, Lyara, for the raid. Yeah, I'm also about to end my stream, so welcome raiders. I'm just gonna check out the quarry here real quick. It's the Minecraft mining machine we built. Yeah, what happens here is those flying machines that are currently parked, pushed forward, and then the slime attaches to the blocks there in front. And then this is one flying machine flies back up and all the blocks with it, so it takes out shaves off a complete layer of the terrain, brings the blocks up, and here the blocks are getting pushed forward. And then here at the top we have a TNT system that drops the TNT down and here blows up the blocks. The items land in a water stream here and are flushed to the side into the stationary water system here, and then brought to the storage system. The first thing we do is we sort out all the cobble and destroy it, and then the rest of the items are put into shulker boxes and stored here. So we can take a look at one of those chests there. So this will be that by accident. So here's what we got in the boxes. Typical terrain, even diamonds. Alright, yeah, that's the quarry.
That's what's being built.
Thanks, Lyara, for the raid. Unfortunately, I'm about to end my stream. Gonna also look for somebody to raid now.
Ration is streaming, building the jungle.
Quarry promised many.
Oh,
is he streaming as well?
I don't know.
But we could also rate Rechen Machine.
I can check.
Doing something on the server. No, my browser doesn't work again. No, it does. Yesterday I had to restart Morale.
Yeah, Manny is streaming too.
Manny's streaming, yeah.
Well, I already promised him. So, I'm gonna rate Manny. He is, the builder on our server is currently working in creative mode on a cyberpunk city that we want to build in survival later. So, that's what Manny is doing. Okay, gonna send you over to Manny. I'm gonna stream tomorrow again. Plan is to stream every day until the quarry is finished and running. So tomorrow again, maybe the day after that.
Yeah. 610 viewers, by the way.
What's going on?
Yeah.
Thanks guys for watching and have fun with Manny. See you next time. Bye bye.
Bye bye.